Welcome, here I've got LG Velvet and I'm gonna show you the top tricks of its camera. So at first we have to tap on the camera button here at the center to open it. And as you can see, we are in the standard photo mode, so let's see what we've got here. And let me start with this settings bar. By going to the left or right, we can change the modes of this camera. We can pick time-lapse, video mode, photo, portrait, sticker. And when we go to the end of the right side, we have more, so we have more modes: night view, panoramic, manual, slow motion, YouTube live, and AR stickers. So this is a lot. I'm not going to speak about this now. I suggest you to make experiments with that and just have a good fun. And now let me go back to the standard photo mode and let me start by tapping on the screen anywhere like that. As you can see, by doing this we have access to this ring. This is the focusing. And also here we have this slider. By tapping on this we can change the exposure compensation of the picture, and we can make our photo just more bright or dark as we need. We can also tap on this MF letters here, so we can change this slider to the manual focus, and we can focusing manually by using this again. So this is really cool here, and this is kind of pro option in this smartphone. So I suggest you to have fun with that. And now let me show you how to zoom. We can do it in two ways. The first one is by tapping on this icon here. We can change the lenses of this camera. So this is the basic zoom. And we can also do it by using two fingers like that. So by doing this, we can get closer to the subject and also go back. This is really easy here. And now let's move to this settings bar, and let me start from the right. The first one button here is the camera timer. So here we can change the delay of taking picture. We can pick from 3, 5 or 10 seconds. So for example, now I'm going to pick 3 seconds to show you how it works. Let me take a picture. And as you can see, the picture was taken with 3 seconds of delay. So let me turn it off now, and let's move to the next one button here. By tapping on this, we can get access to the flash. We can turn on flash every time we take a picture here. We can turn it on auto, so the camera recognizes when it's too dark. And also here we can turn it off easily like that. Now let's move to this button at the center. Here we have access to the filters, and we can make our picture just more beautiful before we take it. As you can see, by using the slider we can pick it. And we have also this slider where we can adjust the strength of this filter. So this is really cool here also. For now, let me stay on the original one, and let's go to the next one button. By tapping on this, we can change the ratio of this camera. We can pick 4 and 3. This is the basic one here. Also 4 and 3 with 48 megapixels, which is the best possible quality of this camera. Here we have access also to 16 and 9. This is a little bit longer one. The next one I want to show you is 1 and 1. So this is the square one, and this is how it changes. And here we have also access to the full screen ratio. So this is how it changes. Now let's go back to the 4 and 3. And let's go to this button here in the left corner. When we tap on this, we can open the advanced camera settings. And here we have a lot of options to manage. Let me focus for now on save options. By tapping on the photo size, we can adjust also the ratio connected with the quality and the size. So these are more advanced settings about the photo resolution. And of course, I suggest you to keep this on the best possible, which is 12 or 48 megapixels to 4 and 3, to 16 and 9 and 1 and 1, this is 9, and to full is 7 megapixels. So this is how it changes. When I change it here, it also changes here. And this is connected with this button, so this is the short access to the ratio. And now let's go again to the settings, and let's move to the HDR here. By tapping on this, we can turn on auto HDR, so the camera recognizes when it's needed. We can turn it on every time we take a picture, and also we can turn it off. So this is really cool. Here I suggest you to keep this on the auto, because the HDR helps to improve the details in the brightest and darkest areas of our pictures, and it really helps to taking our picture just more beautiful. Now let's move to the useful features, and let me focus on this one, option live photo. By using this button we can easily turn it on and turn it off like that. So let me keep this turned on. This is one of my favorite functions in the smartphones. So by taking, when we have this turned on, by taking a picture we have also a short clip, so two in one. And let's go back to take a photo. And now let's go here to the left corner at the bottom. When we tap on this, we get quick access to the gallery. And as you can see, we have the picture with some short clip. This is how it looks like. This is really cool. And now let's go back here. And let's go here to the grid. So for now, let me keep turned off the live photo, so it should be easier to show you other options, and let me pick this for now. So these are the grid lines. By using this button we can turn it on, and let's go back. As you can see, it generates us these lines. This is helpful when we want to use the rule of third in photography and making experiments with composition. Also remember that these lines are not visible at the real picture. They are only to help us taking better photos. So when I take a photo and go again to the gallery, we can't see these lines. And of course, when we don't need it, we can easily turn it off by going again to the settings in the left, sliding to the grid, tapping on this, and for now it's gone. So this is how it works. Now let's move to the next one option I want to show you, and this is the cheese shutter here. By using this button we can also turn it on and turn it off. This is also a really cool option, because here we can take a picture by saying just one word without touching the screen. For example, it can be cheese, smile, whiskey, kimchi or LG. So let me go back and let me try to take a photo by just saying, for example, smile. And as you can see, the picture was taken with just one word. Now let's move to the add signature option here. By using this, we can add the camera watermark. This is really cool that here we can add our own watermark without the device watermark. So for example, let me pick hard reset. And as you can see here, we have the preview. We can also pick the font we want to. So this is how it changes here. So let me stay on the handwriting now, for example, and let me add this. So let's go back to the camera and take a picture. Now let's go again to the gallery here. And as you can see, the watermark is here. And this is how it looks like. So this is really easy. Of course, we can turn it off when we don't need it by just tapping on this button like that. Now let's move to this one option, tag location. So by using this we can easily turn off and turn on the camera location tags. And also the important information here is that when we really want to save the actual location of our picture, to make it work correctly we have to be connected with the internet, for example the Wi-Fi, and we have to turn on the location of this device. So remember about these two parameters when you want to save the location at the picture. And now let's go back again and take another photo. And once again to the gallery. So this is the picture, and to check the location we have to go here to the right corner. When we tap on this we can pick the location information or the details. So when we tap the location information we have access to show it on map, for example. And this is how it looks like. And when we pick the details we have the advanced location with the address. So greetings from Krakow, this is how it works here. And that's all, thanks for watching, subscribe our channel and leave the thumbs up.